Hello friends, welcome to next lecture on rolling contact bearings. I am Dr. Sandeep Wangikar, welcomes you for the next lecture related to selection of bearings from manufacturer catalog. It is a very important task to select the bearing from manufacturer's catalog. So today we will discuss what are the different steps and then we will solve two numericals based on it, so that you will be in a position to solve the numericals and you will get an idea about how the bearings are selected from manufacturer's catalog. So what are different steps in this selection of bearing? So very first, they calculate the radial and axial forces acting on the bearing and determine the diameter of shaft where the bearing is to be fitted. If you see, this radial and axial forces are nothing but calculation of FR and FA, and we should know the diameter on which the bearing is required to be fitted. Then next, select the type of bearing. Generally we will discuss here the problems related to rolling contact bearing. Third step, determine the values of X and Y, that is radial and thrust factors, from the catalog. See, step number 3 is the most crucial step in this selection of bearing from manufacturer's catalog. Total there are 7 steps. Out of these, step number 3 is crucial step in it. The values of X and Y factors are given in one table, and these values are depend upon the two ratios FA by FR and FA by CO, where FA stands for axial load, FR stands for radial load, and CO stands for the static load carrying capacity of the bearing. So these are 3 steps. Let us have some discussion about the calculation of X and Y factors. The selection of bearing is completely a trial and error process. To begin with, we have to select the light series of bearing, assuming that 60, the light 0th series we will select, and we will proceed further for the calculation of these points FA, FR and FA, CO. Now if we select the bearing light series, FA and FR are given, or we have calculated, then we require for selection of X and Y factors the factor CO, that is static load carrying capacity, and we will get the value of CO if we will select the light series of bearing by trial and error method. See here, these are from list dimensions 15-20 mm up to 75 mm. This is nothing but the manufacturer's catalog given. So let us understand the catalog. Here the principal dimensions, D small stands for the inner dia, bore dia, capital D stands for the outer diameter, and B stands for the width of bearing. Then capital C, that is C stands for dynamic load carrying capacity, and CO, static load carrying capacity. Now if we will say that we have to select the 60, see here, for diameter 40, there are 4 bearings given: 6008, 6208, 6308 and 6408. Out of these 4, in the initial stage, if I want to select, I will start with 6008 bearing, and the related CO 9300 as a static load carrying capacity I will take. I will put in this and I will proceed for the calculation. So this is just an example. In the initial stage, we have to select a bearing having the less or lighter series, and then we will proceed for the calculation by trial and error method. Next, let us discuss about this X and Y. If you have the FA by FR and FA by CO ratios, assume that you have calculated FA by FR and your FA by FR value is approximately 0.041. So it is nearer to this 0.041. I will select this row where E value is a factor, it is 0.24. Now you have already calculated Fa by Fr. So let us check whether the Fa by Fr is less than E or greater than E. And accordingly you will choose this row, or accordingly you will choose this row, this column. So this is the general guidelines. Again, you will come to know how to select the values when we will solve a detailed problem based on this. So friends, now we are in step number 3 only, selection of or calculation of x and y factors. Let us move further. Step number 4, calculate the equivalent dynamic load from the equation. Now assuming that Fr and Fa calculated, x and y calculated from step number 3, I will get the value of equivalent dynamic load P. Step number 5, make a decision about the expected bearing life and express in million revolutions. So generally in numericals L10 is given in million revolutions. If it is not given, if it is given in hours, we have to convert that life in million revolutions so that we will put in load life relationship and we can proceed for calculation of dynamic load carrying capacity. Next step is to calculate the dynamic load carrying capacity C. P we have calculated, L10 in million revolutions, you will get the answer for capital C. Now friends, we have to check whether whatever the C we have calculated here, it is suitable for whatever bearing we have selected. For example, the C value, you have compared the C value with the chart. I will go back for some time. See, your C, what we have discussed, that our 6008, your C value is 16,800. Now friends, if you proceed further and you will get the C value which is lesser than that 16,800, whatever bearing you have selected is capable of taking the load. If your C value, for example, it is 21,000 and permitted for that 60 bearing is 16,800, then whatever bearing selected, it will not have the capacity to take the load. Go for next series, that is next bearing I will select, and I will continue the process. I will not stop by selecting next series. I will continue the process for step number 3. Again calculation of CO, static load carrying capacity. Again calculation of XY factors. And again step number 4, 5, 6. Until and unless you will get the C value is having the capacity, whatever you have selected, the bearing will be having capacity to transfer that particular load. So therefore, once again I will say this is a trial and error method. So friends, let us discuss two problems. First problem, very simple, we will discuss, in which we will directly know x and y factor calculation based on whatever discussion we have made just now, that we will discuss. And in second numerical, we will have some more calculation part, trial and error we will apply, and we will discuss further things. So numerical 1. A single row deep groove ball bearing is subjected to pure radial force of 3 kN. Fr is equal to 3 kN from a shaft which rotates at 600 rpm. The expected life is 30,000 hours and diameter is 40 mm. So here see, Fr is given 3 kN. I will convert as 3000 Newton. Life in hours 30,000 hours. RPM is given 600 and diameter is given 40. So this is the given data. Let us proceed further for selection of bearing from manufacturer's catalog. Now I will not go by step 1, 2, 3 because many things are given. So bearing is subjected to pure radial load. The formula is P is equal to XFR plus YFA. But as we have discussed in last lecture, there is no FA, there is no question of X and Y factors. When there is a word pure radial load, the P will be equal to FR only. Therefore P is equal to FR is equal to 3000 Newton. Then we have to convert the bearing life in million revolutions if it is given in hours. So see friends, here we are having formula L10 is equal to 16N L10H divided by 10 raised to 6. N is given 600 rpm. L10H is 30,000 hours. If I put these both values, then see the values are substituted for N 600 and for L10 as 30,000. I will get the value of L10 as 1080 million revolutions. Now next task is to carry or calculate the dynamic load carrying capacity of the bearing. We are having formula, friends, for calculating the dynamic load carrying capacity of a rolling contact bearing, ball bearing. Again, C is equal to P into L10 raised to 1 by 3. C, friends, P value here 3000 Newton, L10 we have converted into million revolutions. So I will substitute the value 3000 into 1080 raised to 1 by 3 and I will get answer 30,779. I will assume 30,780 Newton for further selection of bearing from manufacturer's catalog. Now this is your dynamic load carrying capacity. Let us discuss how the bearing is selected from the manufacturer's catalog. This is, we have calculated having dynamic load carrying capacity of the bearing 30,780. Here I have put in front of you the catalog for 40 mm diameter bore. Here these are different bearings given. The basic load rating C we have to compare. Very, very important, friends, the dynamic load carrying capacity. The load is 30,780. Therefore the bearing should have at least some value greater than this, then and then and only we can say the bearing will safely calculate and will have 30,000 hours life as stated in the numerical. So let us go 4160, no, 13,300, again it is lesser, 16,800, again it is lesser, 30,700 and 30,780, 80 Newton difference is there. So this bearing can be suitable. See, friends, what I am saying, can be suitable for what is our actual criteria. The value of this dynamic load, it should be greater than this. So here by neglecting a difference of 80 Newton, I will write bearing 6208 is suitable. But if we don't want to take the risk, I will proceed for further and I will take dynamic load carrying capacity 41,000. 30,780 is much, much lesser than this 41,000. Therefore, I will select the bearing as 6308. Bearing having designation 6308 is selected from the catalog having bore diameter 40. Capital D, the outside diameter of the bearing 90 millimeters and width of the bearing 23 millimeters. So, we can say bearing number 6308 is suitable for our problem or suitable for whatever things given, having the dynamic load carrying capacity 41,000. The bearing 6308 is suitable. Let us have numerical number 2. We will discuss quite more details here. A single row deep groove ball bearing is subjected to radial force of 8 kN and thrust force of 3 kN. The shaft rotates at 1200 rpm. The expected life L10H hours, it is given 20,000 and the minimum acceptable diameter is given 75 millimeters. We have to select the bearing for this application. So this is the given data. FR is given as 8 kN, FA is given as 3 kN. The shaft rotate as 1200 rpm. Expected life is 20,000 hours and minimum acceptable diameter is 75 millimeters. So with this given data, we will proceed further. Step number very first, whatever given data is there, we will directly go to step number 3 as the bearing diameter and FR and FA given. We have to go here by trial and error methods for calculation of X and Y factors. See here, very important, friends. FR and FA, both values are given. If there is only FR, pure radial loading conditions, X is equal to 1 and Y should be equal to 0. But here FR and FA values are given. Y should not be equal to 0. Then we will neglect the condition FA by FR is less than E. Therefore, here only one possibility is there. At both values, there should be X and Y values and both FR and FA values are given. Therefore, let us concluding FA by FR is greater than E. Now, if you look towards value X, it is 0.56 for all the cases. If you look towards value y, the minimum value is 1 and maximum value is 2.0. Now here we don't have FA by CO. So some another approach I am telling in this. So you can go for selection of lower series bearing, and then you can calculate CO, you can calculate FA by CO, and then selecting that value. Here I will do some different trial. So here y value is 1 and 2. Taking average of this, I will assume the y value at 1.5 in the initial stage, and I will cross check whether the selected is bearing is right or wrong. So here the x value at 0.56 and y value at neither 1 nor 2, a between middle value I have preferred as 1.5. So let us friends, x is equal to 0.56 and y is equal to 1.5. FR is given as 8000 newton and FA is given as 3000 newton. So we are having FR, x, FA, y. We can easily calculate the equivalent load acting on the bearing. P is given by XFR plus YFA. So let us calculate P is equal to XFR plus YFA. Substituting all these values, you will get the answer 8980 newton for P. Let us go for converting the life in hours to life in million revolutions. 60 NL 10H divided by 10 raised to 6. RPM is given 1200. Hours are given 20,000. So we will get the answer 1440 million revolution as L10. Now we are having L10, we are having P. We can easily calculate the dynamic load carrying capacity, C. We are having formula, C is equal to P into L10 raised to 1 by 3. P value 8980 newton, L10 value 1440. We can easily calculate the C value, dynamic load carrying capacity, 101406.04 newton. Now friends, this is the value, and from this value for a series of 75 millimeters we have to calculate the, we have to select the bearing from the catalogue. This is our next step, selection of bearing. C value rounded 101407. This is the catalogue given. Now see here, 75 millimeters, C value. So 12,000, 28,000, 39,000, 66,000, no, 1,12,000, 1,01,000. So this 1,12,000 value is greater than the load acting on the bearing. Therefore, I will select 6315 designated bearing, or bearing number 6315 having CO, static load carrying capacity 72,000, and dynamic load carrying capacity 112,000 newton. So from this application, bearing number 6315 is selected with C value 112,000 and CO value 72,000. Now we have gone for friends trial and error calculation. Now we are having value of CO. Let us proceed further. Calculation of X and Y factor once again based on the CO value, and check whether our selected bearing is having capacity to transfer the load or not. Using the value of CO, FA by FR 3000 by 8000 and FA by CO 72,000, you will get 0.04167. Again, coming to the table, 0.04167 is approximately, I will say, nearby 0.040, E value 0.24. FA by FR 0.375, E value 0.24. So we can easily conclude that this FA by FR 0.375 is greater than 0.24. Therefore, these values are acceptable. Now, X value 0.56. Y value, I can say it is approximately equal to 1.8. But if we, this 1.8 value is concerned with 0.040, we are having 0.04167. So this value for 0.04167 FA by CO can be calculated by using interpolation for these two values, 0.040, 0.070 and 1.8, 1.6. So that value will be somewhat this lesser than 1.8. So the interpolation, you can calculate Y value, 1.8 minus 1.8 minus 1.6 divided by 0.07 minus 0.04 into whatever value we require, 0.04167 minus 0.04. So it is 1.79. I have already said it will, you can take by assuming 0.41.8 as y, but I have gone for more precise calculation. So this is the y value 1.79 and x value 0.56 constant. Now using these calculated x and y values, let us proceed for calculation of p once again. So p is equal to xfr plus yfa. Here I have substituted the new value 1.79 and here it is 9850 newton. Again go for calculation of dynamic load carrying capacity. P into L10 raised to 1 by 3. The changed or new value of P I have substituted here. L10 as it is we have calculated. Now it is 111230 newton. Let us check once again. Select the bearing from the manufacturer's catalogue. So we are having the value of capital C, dynamic load carrying capacity, as 112230. And we have selected here the value bearing 6315. If you select this value 1100230 and 1200, again this bearing is suitable having designation 6315. So whatever bearing we have selected is suitable for this application. The whatever the C value, dynamic load carrying capacity acting on the bearing, is lesser than capacity having bearded by the bearing. Therefore we can conclude that bearing number 6315 is suitable for given application having dynamic load carrying capacity C is equal to 112,000 newton. So friends, here we will conclude. Today we have discussed about the selection procedure for a bearing from manufacturer's catalog and we have discussed two numericals. Thank you very much.